5 pros and 5 cons of colonizing Titan instead of Mars. Everyone talks about living on Mars, but have you thought about living on another planet or moon? Like Titan, Saturn's biggest moon? What if I said it might be a better choice than Mars? Here are 5 pros and cons of colonizing it rather than the red planet. Number 1 pro. Abundant atmosphere shields from radiation. One of the main reasons why it would be preferable to colonize Titan rather than Mars is the presence on Titan of a very dense protective layer, the atmosphere. This dense atmosphere serves as a natural shield against harmful cosmic radiation, offering crucial protection for potential colonists. Unlike Mars and the Moon, which lack significant atmospheres, the one on Titan is nitrogen-rich and drastically reduces the levels of incoming radiation. This shielding effect is essential for long-term human habitation, as prolonged exposure to cosmic radiation can lead to serious health issues, including increased cancer risk and cognitive impairment. Surprisingly enough, studies have shown that Titan's atmosphere is more than 50% denser than Earth's, effectively mitigating the effects of galactic cosmic radiation. The very existence of this protective layer would also make Titan a cheaper option than Mars when it comes to space exploration, as it not only shields the surface but also reduces the need for extensive radiation shielding in habitats and spacecraft. Furthermore, Titan benefits from Saturn's immense magnetosphere, which extends far beyond the Moon and provides an additional layer of protection against charged particles from the Sun. This dual protection from both Titan's atmosphere and Saturn's magnetic field significantly enhances the safety and well-being of potential colonists, offering a more hospitable environment for long-duration stays. Number 2 pro. No need for pressurized suits. Also, wearing clothes would be easier on Titan. Forget about those clumsy astronauts on the Moon stuffed in their suits. Titan's relatively high surface air pressure, approximately 50% greater than Earth's, eliminates the need for such cumbersome pressurized suits traditionally required for extraterrestrial exploration. Unlike Mars, where the atmospheric pressure is less than 1% of Earth's, Titan's atmosphere allows for comfortable mobility and reduced reliance on bulky protective gear. Of course, colonists on Titan would still require specialized suits equipped with heating elements and oxygen supplies to withstand the extreme cold and maintain breathable air. However, these suits would not need to withstand the same pressure differentials as those used on Mars or in space, resulting in lighter, more flexible designs that enhance mobility and efficiency. Perhaps they'll be able to enjoy some dancing during the cold Titan Saturday nights. Not only that, the absence of pressurized suits simplifies daily activities and reduces the risk of mobility-related injuries, enabling colonists to focus more on scientific research, exploration, and resource utilization. Number 3 pro. Rich nitrogen atmosphere. We already mentioned that the atmosphere is very thick, and on Titan it would represent protection for colonists. But what if I told you that there's more to that? This moon's atmosphere could even be used as a resource. How is that possible, you ask? Let me break it down for you. Titan boasts the richest known nitrogen atmosphere in the solar system, with nitrogen comprising over 98% of its atmospheric composition. This abundance provides a readily available resource for sustaining human life and supporting various industrial processes. Think about the endless use we could make of nitrogen. This element serves as a crucial component for creating breathable air, as well as for synthesizing fertilizer, industrial chemicals, and propellants. By utilizing Titan's existing nitrogen reservoirs, colonists can minimize the need for costly imports from Earth, reducing dependency on external supply chains and enhancing long-term sustainability. Additionally, Titan's nitrogen-rich atmosphere offers potential opportunities for terraforming and atmospheric engineering, enabling future efforts to modify the Moon's climate and enhance habitability. By leveraging Titan's abundant nitrogen resources, colonists could unlock new avenues for scientific discovery and exploration, paving the way for broader human expansion across the solar system. Extracting nitrogen from the surface of Mars is also theoretically possible, but it presents significant challenges due to the planet's thin atmosphere and nitrogen-poor environment. The atmosphere of Mars is primarily composed of carbon dioxide, with nitrogen making up only about 2.6% of its atmospheric composition. This is much less abundant compared to Earth or Titan. Number 4 pro, lakes of hydrocarbons for energy and construction. Here's something else that will blow your mind. Titan's surface is filled with lakes, rivers, and seas. Only they're not the water ones we're used to. They're mainly made of liquid methane and ethane. These are some of the most important organic molecules, and these lakes, rivers, and seas create a unique environment rich in hydrocarbon resources. Unlike Mars, where methane and ethane reservoirs are technically possible but have yet to be found, Titan's surface features abundant reserves of liquid methane and ethane readily accessible for colonization. How could colonists use them? As a source of energy, for starters. They would be able to generate power to use this energy for transportation and industrial processes. By harnessing the energy potential of methane and ethane, colonists can establish self-sufficient energy systems capable of meeting the moon's diverse needs. Furthermore, Titan's hydrocarbon resources extend beyond energy production to include construction materials for habitat construction and infrastructure development. With these elements at their disposal, colonists can manufacture lightweight, durable polymers, ideal for building surface structures and protective enclosures. The availability of locally sourced hydrocarbons reduces reliance on Earth-based imports and enables greater autonomy for the colony, fostering a more resilient and self-sustaining settlement model. On Mars, none of this would be possible. So, do you still have doubts? Number 5, pro. Resources nearby and potential for exploration. Last but not least, among the pros of settling on Titan, there is its strategic location within the Saturnian system. Saturn and its nearby moons offer unparalleled access to a wealth of resources and exploration opportunities. Think about Enceladus, with its subsurface ocean of liquid water. While it is true that also Mars is known to be hosting water ice reservoirs, it would likely be easier to extract water from Enceladus than the red planet. Enceladus has a subsurface ocean beneath its icy crust, offering a potentially abundant and easily accessible water resource. Mars, while believed to have water in the form of ice and possibly subsurface reservoirs, presents challenges due to its thin atmosphere, surface complexities, and greater distance from Earth. Therefore, colonists could use this tiny icy moon as a virtually endless water reservoir. Not only that, celestial bodies like Enceladus are ideal places to look for life as we know it. Colonizing Titan would also pave the way for groundbreaking discoveries in astrobiology and searching for signs of extraterrestrial life. Additionally, Titan's diverse geological features and atmospheric conditions make it an ideal destination for scientific exploration and experimentation. From studying its methane lakes and hydrocarbon cycle to analyzing its unique weather patterns and surface chemistry, Titan presents a myriad of research opportunities with implications for planetary science. In other words, colonizing another solar system body would in turn improve our overall understanding of the universe. By establishing a foothold on Titan, humanity can expand its presence in the outer solar system and lay the groundwork for future missions to explore distant worlds and unlock the mysteries of the cosmos. Expanding on the pros outlined so far, it becomes evident that Titan offers a compelling destination for future human colonization and exploration, perhaps even more than Mars. With its abundant resources, protective atmosphere, and strategic location within the Saturnian system, this moon would represent a unique opportunity for future settlers. But what about the cons? Let's see why it would not be advisable to colonize Titan instead of Mars. Before moving on, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Make sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on our daily videos. Number 1. Con: extreme cold and harsh environment. First of all, Titan's surface temperature averages around minus 180 degrees Celsius or minus 292 degrees Fahrenheit, making it one of the coldest places in the solar system. Such extreme cold presents significant challenges for human habitation, requiring advanced thermal insulation and heating systems to maintain habitable conditions. Protecting colonists and infrastructure from extreme cold necessitates the development of robust thermal management systems. Without adequate protection, equipment and infrastructure could become brittle or malfunction, compromising the colony's viability. So, while the presence of a very thick atmosphere could lead us to wear unpressurized suits, the very cold temperature would require the development of more heating systems. How would our Saturday night look like then? Number 2 con: distance and cost of transportation. Titan's distance from Earth, over 1.2 billion kilometers or 746 million miles, poses formidable challenges for transportation and logistics. Traveling to Titan requires advanced spacecraft capable of withstanding long-duration missions and traversing vast distances. The high cost of developing and launching spacecraft for interplanetary travel presents a significant barrier to colonization efforts. Additionally, the prolonged travel time to reach Titan increases mission complexity and resource requirements, further elevating the overall cost. Number 3 con: limited sunlight for solar energy. Just like the thick atmosphere brings its pros, it also comes with some cons. This feature, coupled with Titan's distance from the sun, reduces the effectiveness of solar energy as a power source. The dim sunlight reaching Titan's surface presents challenges for solar panel efficiency, limiting the viability of solar power as a primary energy source. Alternative energy solutions such as nuclear reactors or methane-based power generation may be necessary to meet the colony's energy needs. Developing and implementing these technologies requires significant investment in infrastructure, and we're probably not ready to take this step yet. The question is then, when will we be? Number 4 con: challenges in food production. With very poor sunlight hitting our Saturnian moon and freezing cold weather, it would be very hard to cultivate food. Sure, we could establish sustainable greenhouse cultivation systems capable of withstanding Titan's harsh environment, but this would require advanced technology and resource management. Doing the same thing on Mars would probably be easier. The Red Planet has a thin atmosphere containing carbon dioxide, which, combined with its relatively moderate temperatures, could support greenhouse cultivation with some modifications. In contrast, as we already mentioned, Titan's cold temperatures would pose significant challenges for plant growth. In any case, developing resilient crop varieties and cultivating microorganisms capable of converting local resources into food are essential for ensuring a sustainable food supply. Overcoming these challenges demands extensive research and innovation in agricultural science and biotechnology. Number 5 con: long-term viability and technological hurdles. Establishing a permanent colony on Titan requires overcoming numerous technological hurdles and ensuring long-term viability. Developing self-sustaining infrastructure capable of supporting human life in Titan's harsh environment is a complex and resource-intensive endeavor. Advanced robotics missions are necessary to prepare the groundwork for human colonization, including constructing habitats, gathering resources, and preparing the environment. Additionally, extensive crew training and interdisciplinary expertise are essential for addressing the unique challenges of life on Titan. Building underground infrastructures on Mars is currently the most preferable option. That's what makes it a con in the case of Titan. As you can understand, despite the potential advantages of colonizing Titan, including its protective atmosphere and abundant resources, the formidable challenges of extreme cold, distance, and technological requirements underscore the complexity of turning this distant moon into a human habitat. Overcoming these challenges will require significant advancements in space exploration, technology, and resource utilization, making colonization a distant prospect awaiting further scientific and technological progress. So, where will humanity settle in the future? Only time will tell. That's all for this video. What would you like us to cover next? Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below and stay tuned for our next video. I'll see you soon on the channel.